Welcome to the life skills class. And today we get you yet another interesting topic. The topic for today is keeping safe. So children, what do we mean by being safe? Yes, it is to protect ourselves from any danger or risk. Safety at home. It is the safest place in the world, that's true. But remember, it is your job to keep yourself safe as well. How can you do that? You must always stay at home with an adult. Remember, do not open medicine cabinets, climb on furniture, touch electrical appliances, like the toaster, iron, geyser, etc. Do not touch electrical sockets and do not operate cooking stove. These things are not meant for small children. And the most important is, do not open the door for strangers. But in case anything goes wrong, or you have opened the door for a stranger, you sense danger, what should you do? Simply shout for help. Some adult will definitely come to help you, whether that adult is at home or in your neighborhood. Somebody will definitely come to help you. Safety in the playground. No doubt, it is a very safe place. Your park is safe. Your playground is safe. But remember, there are other people also in the park and playground who may not be very nice, and you should stay away from them. So, remember to always be under adult supervision. Use playing equipments properly. Wait for your turn, only so that you don't get hurt. And of course, never speak to any adult or stranger you do not know. But what if they continue to talk to you? You must step away from them, shout for help, run back to your parents. But if you have been separated from your parents, locate somebody who looks familiar, who you think can help you. And then ask that person to take you home and contact your parents. So for this, you need to remember your home address and the phone numbers of your parents. Safety in a mall. Always walk with your parents or hold their hand. Do not sit or play on the railings, you will get hurt. And never, never wander away. But should you get separated, what should you do? Do not leave the store or the mall. Stay where you are. Look for a friendly face or a help desk. Ask them to contact your parents. For this, again, you will need to remember your home address or the phone numbers of your parents. And remember, your parents will also be looking for you. Somebody is always watching out for you, so you will be safe. Now, in all these situations, one more thing can happen. What if the friendly stranger, the friendly person who is helping you reach your parents, they do not get the numbers of your parents? They are not contactable. What do you do? So you must remember the contact details of other relatives as well. And for this, to keep all this information, you can make an address book. Let's see what that is. An address book has names and numbers of those who can help you in case of emergency. It should have your home address, your landline number, and definitely the numbers of your mother, father, grandfather, grandmother, or relatives who can help you in case of emergency. So, apart from your parents, you must remember 2-3 other numbers in case your parents' number people are not able to contact. Then there can be somebody else who can come to fetch you. Discuss the numbers and the contact details you want to add in your address book. Discuss this with your parents. Make an address book. Yes, decorate it the way you want. Keep it handy so that you can keep looking into the contact numbers and the address and remember it. Okay? And definitely keep it where you can find it. So on that note, I come to the end of the class. Yes, safety is very important for everyone, including us adults. We all should be doing such things and keeping ourselves safe. Remember, getting scared or crying is not a solution. We must be alert enough to help ourselves get out of the difficult situation. And these little things can help you a long way. So I hope you've liked this topic as much as I have. I will see you again in the next class. Till then, stay at home, stay safe. Bye-bye.